I am presently much more interested in clubs and things. This was Jakar starting equipment. I have stronger stuff already. Sledgehammer. That will come in really handy. Frozen club, that is good stuff. And it only requires blood, so maybe I'll have Joseph carry that around. Right. Well, I'll have to double check my inventory here. Bone swords. Yeah, I can't seem to sell those. Oh well, I'll destroy one of them. And the fire falchion. 13 revive scrolls. I do feel kind of naked with so few revive scrolls. Let's see if I can buy some more. No, that's not what I do here. Okay, never mind. So, Mr. Tancred person. Or do I speak to you directly? Yeah, right. Apothecary, okay. That's the dude who sent us to fight the fiery Salamanca. And now that we have a full party, I'm going to try to do that. Although, since that quest has vanished from our quest list, I worry that I've locked myself out of it. Maybe you can only do it with Joseph and Fleece. That is before Iona. That's kind of harsh. That is a tough fight, as I hope you'll see. So forcing you to fight with only two characters at the start of this game, that's just mean, honestly. That's just that's really quite nasty. Okay, so we should be close to the apothecary. Yeah, he's right over there. Good. Well, 10 gold remains 10 gold. Okay, so a few revive scrolls. Because why not? Okay, I'm actually going to make a preemptive save here. Right. So the game apparently is apparently hard coded to use US keyboard layout. I really don't like that. Well, I mean, okay, it's really not a big deal. Honestly, and the buttons you usually use, they are mostly unchanged. I think none of the important hotkeys are changed in any way between the keyboard layouts, but just forcing a layout onto the player, just don't do that. Okay, so let's see what we have. Ring of Stone and Fire. We are doing that right now. And we have some random encounters. Right. Huh. Oh yeah, and I could also probably buy some pretty fancy equipment for fleece. But I think I'll risk it. So, now we are on the world map. And first order of business, no, not the outskirts. I want to try to find the fiery Salamanca, and you'll find it in the mountains, which is over here. It's kind of unpredictable. I mean, you don't expect it, at least the first time you play. Usually areas like this will be quite impassable. Oh, this is the wrong encounter. This is not the encounter you're looking for. Okay, well, that encounter was a whole lot of nothing, and Joseph ended up learning one new chain attack, and Rosalind gained a level. Not terribly exciting, but still, stuff happened. Okay, that was more of the same. Getting a little worried. These quest random encounters usually pop up pretty quickly. Oh! Hi. These, I'm just gonna tell you in case you can't see, are Khosani. And they are trying to kill us because I don't know. I'm hoping there will be well, maybe there's some kind of rebels. I don't know. Creatures do we have around us? Oh, hi. There's one thing to note about these enemies here. This is your first and probably best chance to get a special weapon. Well, I mean, I say special, but it has the special property of poisoning your enemy. That special trait comes in really, really, really a lot of handy at a certain point in the game when you are up against an enemy that cannot be, well, really cannot be hurt with any normal weapons or damage. So, yeah. The golden tactic is then to simply poison the thing and just hang back and let the poison do its work. And just, well, cheese the fight that way, as it were. There are supposed to be other solutions to such a fight, though. And much less randomness involved. And I am now controlling Jakar to try to learn some chain attacks, or at least put points into his One or two of the attacks that your car gets are going to be, well, basically indispensable in, what was the name again? In Akimos. Okay, a little more sword for you. Have another backstab. Dodge. Dodging never hurt. Also, as you can see, Jakar is now carrying the shard sword. The ever so badass 70 damage and 0.74 speed weapon. So he's quite strong, at least against enemies that have the decency to be vulnerable to sword damage. And I was glitched out a bit by the transparent leaves. Oh, hi. You. Aha! Yes! That's the item I was talking about. Let me show you real quick. Well, it has a stupid amount of value. Wow. So it should sell for a lot of money, that's good. It has so-so damage, but high speed. Critical hits +3, that's a good thing. And the poison effect, equipable by Joseph and Fleece. Now Fleece, unfortunately, has something better equipped already, but we are hanging on to this. We are not letting go of it. May just... I don't think there's anyone else hoping to jump out and stab us in the face. No. Okay. Oh. Oh joy. Iron gauntlets. I should probably equip those on your car straight away. Gives him some more protection. Okay, so this encounter was also a whole lot of nothing. Well, I kind of want to get on with things, so if the next encounter isn't the Fire Salamanca encounter, I will be running ahead to the other subquests in the area. Taurus loot. And whatever else there was. Pathfinder AI is interesting in this game. Well, hey, what are you gonna do? You have like 273 metrics to make do with.
I have gained new input.
Dude, no. That's it. I am pulling out a mirror.